So you want to win an NCAA championship. Some think it's easy, and on paper, maybe it is. Just win the next six games in a row, and you've reached your goal. But as Dickie B is going to tell you, these are the toughest six games to play. And you'll see that in today's game between the SMU Mustangs and the Tennessee Volunteers.
Hey, Brad, the NCAA tournament is the reward. After a long season of practices, tough games, and all of those other rigors, the tournament is their pinnacle.
And the first half has officially begun. The Volunteers are looking to make this one a blowout early. What are the keys for them tonight, Dick?
Yeah, on a night like this, the keys are pretty simple, Brad. First, get the ball to your big man on the block early. That'll open up the perimeter game, baby. Second of all, make sure every possession you have is a good possession. Don't turn the rock over. And finally, make your team think defense first. Solid defense will lead to good offense.
Well, partner, I say let's get to the action on the court, and we'll see how this one plays out. He's getting lost on every move.
We got to see more heart on defense. This defender is resilient. Still applying pressure.
That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn. I tell you, the jump hook so effective, especially against a big post player. Very difficult to block that shot.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Bed the low block. Puts up the tray. Well, thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. Trying to pack it inside. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job in post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way.
In the paint, he attempts a jump hook. Can't get the shot to go. Inside.
Oh, poor job. Poor job offensively. I'm coaching. He's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. He's pounding the ball to the deck. Where's he going?
On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. Here's the offensive drop step in the low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
Inside, top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. Fakes the jumper. They go inside, and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Fields is feeling great right now.
Well, you know, Brad, these student-athletes play with fire and emotion. You rarely see that in the pros. Nice fake.
He tries a jump hook, and in and out.
No matter how you describe it, a stop here will excite all of the fans.
For two.
I love the sky hook, especially when you get great post position on the interior.
Down inside, he makes a nice shot fake. He up fakes. Let's check in with Aaron Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Aaron.
Well, Brad and Dick, with the score so close, both teams seem so intense on their benches right now. Both coaches have told me it all comes down to turnovers and miscues.
All right, thanks, Aaron. He goes up with a jumper. Off the mark. He's going nowhere. Ball stolen. It's going the other way. That's where it's going.
Turnover city, baby. Gotta eliminate those turnovers.
Tries to turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
Offense gets it back after that ball was knocked loose. They've yet to put together a decent string of good looks at the basket.
Hey, they're getting frustrated and playing right into the defense's hand.
Pass down low. There's a drop step, and oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step. Very slow.
The center with the ball. He gets the rejection. Shows patience, waiting for the reset. For the bucket, and he missed. beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
He's definitely hogging the ball like you hog the microphone.
Hey, sure he is. I can hear snorting from the ear.
He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it.
He tries the three. Way off target. At the half, the Mustangs are ahead by two. Let's take a look back and watch the play of the half. Tennessee had a horrid first half shooting the rock.
Well, they didn't exactly spend time looking for high percentage shots, and it cost them big time. If this goes on for the next 20 minutes, they may not walk out of here with a W tonight.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
Thanks, Aaron. On the outside, Moss receives the pass. Basket falls despite the contact.
Coach looks on, focused, a lot of intensity. A lot of emotion.
Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing. He's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
Gave it up. Looking for the foul. He puts it in with contact and all. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
The kick out. The shooting guard takes the pass. He's not even looking for the open man, Dick.
They might need a quick TO, baby.
The center receives the ball. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
And the ball goes out of bounds. There's a slam. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough, and a great reaction by the defensive post player.
Let's watch the defense down in the low block.
See, first, initially, he wants a three-quarter. Then he plays him where he gets good post position, so he's able to get the ball. A good rebounding position, a good block out. And that's essential in a post. A lot of guys don't realize part of post play is ultimately a block out and get good rebound position.
The power forward handles the pass. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
On the inside. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job on the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, the coaching staff knew this would be a key heading into tonight's matchup. This is something they stressed during pregame, and it's something they're talking about on the benches right now. The message, get the ball inside. Guys, they're doing that.
Thanks, Aaron.
I'll tell you one thing, she's essentially right. Down in the post is where you create a lot of offensive action.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, guys, after all, this is the NCAA Finals. In talking with both coaches before the game, they figured it would be a close game from start to finish. I'm certainly looking forward to the game's ending.
Picks off the pass. The ball goes out of bounds. I've seen you out there with pom-poms, Mr. Vitale, but not looking that good.
I tell you what, don't look that good. I can't dance like that, baby.
Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
The power forward takes the feed. The ball goes out of play. I don't even know if you and I can find a seat in this place, Dick.
I tell you one thing, you get the home court advantage when you got a crowd like this. By the way, you and I have the best seat in the house.
The shooting guard handles the feed, and he scores despite the hack. Timeout, they want to talk it over right here. And with that timeout, we go to the third member of our broadcast team. Aaron?
Well, guys, this is a great opportunity for the coaches to calm their teams down. With this much time remaining, they're stressing play smart basketball and take care of the ball.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Let's get back to the action. 6 points separating these two squads.
This is no time to get complacent, Brad.
The shooting guard gets the pass. On the dribble, gives it up. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
And the ball goes out of play. You talk about a great drive. How about the State Farm drive of the game?
I tell you, he was explosive. He was up, up, and away. What a drive to the rack, baby. That was special.
The lead is six.
Hey, a tray here in this place will go absolutely bananas, Brad. I can feel it.
He shoots from the baseline. He can't get the hoop to fall. Pushes it up, controlling the ball. Great defense. Timeout's called.
And Coach, let's just talk about how they're going to overcome this big deficit.
Get back out on the floor.
Don't waste a lot of time. Foul right away.
Defense getting back to prevent an easy bucket.
The defender is still applying great ball pressure, Brad.
Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Dick. Foul, and that stops the clock again. And the clock stopped with a foul.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
There's the turnover situation for the half, Dick.
I'd say the lower the number, the better off your team will be. With too many turnovers, the likelihood of you playing in a game at the end drops significantly.
And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here.
Brad, I think they'll continue to do so in an attempt to get back in the ball game. They should look to foul the opponent's weakest free throw shooter.
Foul, and that stops the clock again. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. He goes to the line for the first time. Misses the front end of the one and one.
They can make it very interesting with a score here. It looks as though they have a shooter spotting up. Foul them early and give your team a chance.
And yet another foul. And we get a look here at our foul and timeout situation.
Hey, Brad, many games are lost because coaches fail to manage the clock, possession, or their timeout situation. Let's see how these coaches fare tonight.
Up and in. Gets the second. They want to talk about it right here, Dick.
They got to find a way to chip up in this lead before it's too late.
We'll be right back. change in the game plan right now, Dick.
Could be. Got to be ready for anything if you're the opposition.
He puts up the tray. Off the rim and no good. Here we go on the break. Dick, I think we saw a good tournament game. Both teams played pretty well, and, you know, I feel bad for the team that's got to go home.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
Tennessee loses a close one.
This is going to be hard to swallow since they were the favorites coming into this game.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler.